This is an information and demonstration tape concerning the Sennheiser vocoder. It has been produced by Studiofunk, Hamburg 13, Kloster Alley 76. Telephone 040-441676. If you have any questions about distribution and for further information, please contact us at the above address.
This introductory sentence has already been a simple example of a vocoded language. Before we continue with further practical examples, we should at this point give some simple and summed up information, at least so far as necessary to fully understand and realize the procedures going on in the following sound experiments. For further details, please feel free to contact either Sennheiser or the above address. Let us begin with the principal consideration. We learn the human language at the baby age, unconsciously by listening and imitating what we hear from the adults. The sounds A, E, E, O, U, for instance, are formed by continuously changing the shape and size of oral and pharyngeal cavities. And through this, by emphasizing certain frequency ranges out of the sound material which is produced by the vocal cords. These sounds we call voiced. Such sounds as S and T and SH, however, are generated from the hissing noise of the airstream, as well as from sudden stowing and releasing of the airflow by lips, tongue, etc. They are called unvoiced. A vocoder consists principally of two different installations, analyzing and synthesizing equipment. If we feed a speech signal into the vocoder, the first task of the analyzing equipment is to distinguish instantly whether there is a voiced or an unvoiced signal taking place at the moment. The second task is to split up the sound material, in this case the human voice, by filtering into as many different frequency ranges as possible, and consequently to measure what is going on in each single channel at any moment in the speech. The sound oo, for instance, will take place preferably in the lower frequency ranges. The sound E, however, more or less in the upper ones. The Sennheiser vocoder splits the speech signal into 20 channels and inquires instantly how strongly the portions of each sound in the speech take place in each channel. The results in the analyzer part are 20 different signals, which activate the synthesizer part of the vocoder again in 20 channels in the manner of valves opening and closing. In this part of the vocoder, the speech is, so to speak, reassembled, not from the original sound material of the language, but from what is called a replacement signal, which can be any sound source, artificial or natural, as long as sufficient frequencies are available to rebuild sounds like ah and oo and s and sh. Each time the vocoder recognizes whether there is a voiced or an unvoiced sound taking place, it switches over alternatively between two inputs, one for voiced, the other one for unvoiced replacement signals. Some of such replacement signals contain sufficient high frequencies even to build S's and T's out of them. In this case, the vocoder can be supplied from one input only. Otherwise, the ideal replacement signal for unvoiced sounds will be white or pink noise, which contains an equal mixture of all audible frequencies. On the Sennheiser vocoder, such noise can be supplied from an internal noise generator or from any other external sound source. Voiced replacement signals can be supplied in many ways. Here again, the Sennheiser vocoder has, mainly for checking purposes, a built-in pulse oscillator as internal sound source, producing a frequency spectrum similar to our vocal cords. Whilst through the external input, any thinkable sound source such as synthesizers, electronic music instruments, tape recordings, noises, or even natural voices can be used to take over the part and the effect of the vocal cords in the original speech signal. Here are some practical examples. First, we use as an original speech signal the German text of a well-known song, which is tape recorded and then originally and identically supplied to the speech input of the vocoder in all the following examples. Here's the original.
Vor der Kaserne, vor dem großen Tor, steht eine Laterne und steht sie noch davor.
We are now using the internal pulse generator as the voiced and the internal noise generator as the unvoiced replacement signals.
Vor der Kaserne, vor dem großen Tor, steht eine Laterne und steht sie noch davor.
The internal noise generator remains in the following examples as the unvoiced replacement signal for replacing S's and T's. But the voiced sounds are now replaced by a Moog synthesizer. Here is a triad of three oscillators, the tuning of which is slowly moved upwards.
Vor der Kaserne, vor dem großen Tor, steht eine Laterne und steht sie noch davor.
We are still using the same sentence as before. The Moog synthesizer oscillator is now modulated by a light vibrato, whilst the pitch is changed by playing on the keyboard, following the famous melody of this song, in the same rhythm as the words were spoken before.
Vor der Kaserne, vor dem großen Tor, steht eine Laterne und steht sie noch davor.
Once again playing the melody on a Moog synthesizer with a single oscillator. In between, we'll change pitch in octave steps by operating the range switch from very low to very high. You will realize how the understandability of the speech will become inadequate at a higher range, as now the replacement signal will not contain sufficient lower frequencies for forming sounds like O and U.
Vor der Kaserne, vor dem großen Tor, steht eine Laterne und steht sie noch davor.
The same text with the same melody. We now modulate the single Moog oscillator with an unnaturally strong vibrato, more or less like somebody trembling for fear.
Vor der Kaserne, vor dem großen Tor, steht eine Laterne und steht sie noch davor.
The same text, or rather the same originally recorded sentence, is now vocoded through six oscillators of a Moog synthesizer, which are played from the keyboard. As the synthesizer is not polyphonic, each single voice has been vocoded by the same sentence on a multi-track recording machine and then mixed together like a choir of artificial voices.
Vor der Kaserne, vor dem großen Tor, steht eine Laterne und steht sie noch davor.
Now we are using the same noise generator which has been used so far to supply unvoiced replacement signals, both for voiced and for unvoiced replacement. As noise contains all audible frequencies, language should become audible and understandable from such material as well. However, it will sound more like a whispering or hoarse voice.
Vor der Kaserne, vor dem großen Tor, steht eine Laterne und steht sie noch davor.
In the following example, the original speech signal is led through the envelope follower of a Moog synthesizer, which reacts to the changing loudness of the original speech with changing control voltages. By connecting them to the oscillator, its pitch now goes up and down in the same manner as the loudness does in the original speech.
Vor der Kaserne, vor dem großen Tor, steht eine Laterne und steht sie noch davor.
In the Sennheiser vocoder, each of the 20 channels of the analyzing part has its own separate output, where the signal of this channel is available, and at the same time made visual by light-emitting diodes. If, for instance, the sound ah is produced, we can see the lamps numbers 7 to 11 illuminated, which means that with this particular sound, the channels 7 to 11 are activated the most. In the following example, we use the summed-up signals of these channels as control voltage for the Moog oscillators, so the pitch will suddenly jump upwards every time an R is spoken. Here is the original sentence with several R sounds, spoken in German.
Ich würde jetzt in die Stadt fahren, aber mein Auto ist kaputt. Der Anlasser arbeitet nicht.
And now the same, vocoded in the prescribed manner.
Ich würde jetzt in die Stadt fahren, aber mein Auto ist kaputt. Der Anlasser arbeitet nicht.
So far, we have used artificial sounds, such as synthesizer oscillators, etc., for replacing the voiced sounds of a language. In the following examples, we'll feed tape recordings of real noises or voices into the vocoder's input for voiced replacement signals. Here, for instance, is the recording of the acoustic background on a football field. With this acoustic material, a shouting crowd, we want to form the following words.
Müller vor! Noch ein Tor!
And here is the vocoded effect of both. In the same manner, we could make any noise speak any words, as long as the replacement signal contains sufficient sound material to cover the range of frequencies needed for understandability.